We have an equilateral triangle ABC and a point inside that triangle that's 1 away from A, root 3 away from B, and 2 away from C. We have to find the side length of the triangle. Now you know we're going to start with a diagram. There's our triangle ABC. And we have a point inside the triangle. One away from A, root 3 away from B, and 2 away from C. Now it's awfully tempting to label each of the sides S, label the angles in here, break out the law of cosines. But I gotta tell you, life's too short for the law of cosines. I see the 1, I see the root 3, I see the 2, I start thinking 30, 60, 90 triangles. So we gotta find a 30, 60, 90 triangle with these lengths. But these three lengths all come out of the same point. Triangles don't work like that. We're gonna have to build that 30, 60, 90 triangle. But how? So I'm gonna start thinking of transforming this diagram, reflecting it, rotating it. Which of those would be best? Well, if we're gonna rotate a problem involving an equilateral triangle, we're gonna be rotating by 60 degrees. You rotate by 60 degrees, you're gonna make some 60 degree angles. Yeah, I like trying that rotation thing, but what do we rotate around? Well, if we rotate around P, that point in the middle there, well, the A, B, and C will end up in the middle of nowhere. I don't know what good that'll do. Am I 1, am I root 3, am I 2? They'll still be connected to P, and triangles still don't work like that, so I'm gonna rotate around A instead. I'm gonna rotate 60 degrees this way. I'm gonna make another equilateral triangle over here. I'm just taking this, I'm gonna spin it like that. So this point inside spins to right here. That's 1 away from A, because we're just rotating, and we're rotating by 60 degrees, so this right here, 60 degrees. And that's really nice, because that means this right here, equilateral triangle. So that means this length right there, that's 1. And then let's take a look at this right here. This square root of 3 right here, when we rotate by 60 degrees, it goes right there. It goes from here to right here. This is root 3. 1. Root 3, 2. We found our 30, 60, 90 triangle. This is a right angle. This over here is 60 degrees. And this is an equilateral triangle. So this in here, this is also 60 degrees. So that tells me this angle, this APC, go ahead and put the P right there, APC is 120 degrees. And now we can break out the law of cosines. Got a side here, length 1, side here, length 2, angle of 120, but life is still too short for the law of cosines. We could solve the problem from here, but this rotation thing's kind of cool. I'm going to look at what happens if I rotate it the other way. If I rotate it this way, let's see what happens. Rotate it this way, this one's going to turn this way, it's going to go like this. And once again, we're going to have that little equilateral triangle right there. This is going to be 60 degrees right in here. And then this is going to rotate to here. So this is 1, this is 2, and this is root 3. Another 30, 60, 90 triangle right here. 1, root 3, 2, that means this is a 90 degree angle. This is 90, this is 60 degrees. This whole angle in here, A, P, B, 150 degrees. So now we've got 1, we've got root 3, we got that 150 degrees in there, and we could use the law of cosines again to find A, B. Life is still too short for the law of cosines. We got 150 over here, we got 120 over there. Put those together, you got 270. All the way around is 360, so right in here, oh yeah, right angle. Which must have you wondering, what would have happened if we'd taken this triangle and rotated it down instead? Try that at home. I think you'll like it. And you'll see that, indeed, life's too short for the law of cosines. We could have gotten straight to that right angle and break out the Pythagorean theorem. 2 squared is 4. Root 3 squared is 3. Add those together, you get 7. Take the square root. Our answer is root 7. That's choice B. And we're done.